BrainyDose presents 7 Reasons Why You Hate People. At one time or another, we all feel annoyed by other people. When someone oversteps, produces irritating sounds, or behaves inappropriately, it's normal to feel aggravated. It's even common to strongly dislike or borderline hate specific people who you deem awful. However, if your hatred applies to more than just those few individuals who may have hurt you in some way, you might begin to despise the entire human race over even the smallest inconveniences. This irritability toward people can end up causing problems in your life, especially regarding regular interactions with others. But if you look deeply, your irritations might reveal some more personal issues that have nothing to do with others at all. Do you truly hate people, or is something else bothering you? If you're wondering why you feel such an aversion to humanity, the following reasons may shed some light. Number 1. You need more time alone. You probably know which personality type you possess when it comes to introversion and extroversion, especially if you keep up with our channel. We've covered both extensively. In short, extroverts are more outgoing and social, while introverts prefer more time alone. Because introverts often struggle with social interaction, the quality of their interactions tends to be reduced. People who are shy and find opening up to others difficult may feel uncomfortable when socializing. Instead of perceiving those who try to get to know them better as friendly, introverts may see them as overbearing and invasive. This phenomenon can cause introverts distress, and as their internal defenses go off, they can even feel angry or outraged. If this sounds like you, your dislike may be rooted in feelings of discomfort. Even if you have a close group of friends and enjoy stepping out of your comfort zone every once in a while, you may need more solitude to recharge after social situations compared to other people. When you're socially drained, you're more likely to feel agitated by others. Instead of pushing yourself to socialize out of obligation, consider taking some alone time to de-stress and unwind before socializing again. Your sense of disdain for others may mean you just need some space. Number 2. You need to learn to agree to disagree. It's impossible for everyone in the world to have the same views, opinions, and beliefs. Sometimes it's extremely difficult to understand another person's perspective when your core belief systems, upbringings, and experiences stand in stark contrast to one another. These different factors cause people to think and feel differently, resulting in strong convictions and even stronger conflicts. Talking to people with different opinions can result in healthy debates and personal growth, but both parties may leave with feelings of distaste or hatred if the arguing gets out of hand. This type of encounter isn't productive, and it can harm everyone involved. You probably see this all the time on social media. Someone shares their opinions with a public status, until someone else, be it a friend, acquaintance, or even a complete stranger, brings in an opposing opinion. Then, the argument escalates into harassment, blocking, or banning. Some internet trolls even provoke others on purpose, aiming for conflict. Interactions like these may cause you to feel angry. You might want to lash out. It's not unusual to feel offended or attacked when someone challenges your opinions, but that doesn't mean that it's healthy. Instead of indulging in hostility, you can change your mindset. Two people can agree to disagree, remain friends, and even continue to discuss the matter, with the shared goals of informing and learning rather than convincing. This perspective will help you become more accepting. You won't always see eye to eye with other people, but you can feel less irritated when disagreements arise. Instead of seeing disagreements as an impossible obstacle, you can choose to accept others' opinions, even when they're different from your own. Just because someone has a different opinion than you doesn't mean they deserve to be hated. Number 3. You hold grudges and struggle to forgive. While it might be easy to forgive a stranger on the internet for not agreeing with your personal preferences, it's much more difficult to dissipate feelings of disdain for someone who has harmed you more intimately. When someone says or does something terrible, or intentionally causes problems in your life, it's easy to think that you hate them. Even though your feelings are valid and may be justifiable, holding on to anger only hurts one person, you. Your hatred can impact your life, relationships, and happiness, even long after the original offense took place. It's time to let go. You need to learn how to let go of your pain and hatred for others, especially toward those who have hurt you deeply. Practicing forgiveness will increase your emotional well-being by reducing distress and negative emotions. Number 4. Your lifestyle needs a change. If you feel like you despise people, the source of your dislike may arise from your lifestyle. People's professions are often a major source of negative emotions like anxiety, irritation, and stress. The most difficult careers often involve working with or dealing with other people. Whether you work in sales, customer service, a law office, or a restaurant, tension and conflict are common. Even though these positions offer plenty of positive experiences as well, like meeting new people and having exciting interactions, on some days, the negative encounters may seem to outweigh the good ones. If you work a job where you constantly interact with others, you might not hate them. You might just be around them too much. When you're stuck in a situation where unpleasant social interactions are a daily occurrence, it's easy to conclude that everyone sucks. Keep in mind that most people don't see what you see, and there are plenty of opportunities out there that involve less social interaction. Whether you deal with people in person or on the phone, you might need a break from a job that causes deep unhappiness and feelings of hate. Think about how you can alter your lifestyle to better meet your social and emotional needs. Number 5. You need to set and reinforce your boundaries. Everyone wants their boundaries to be respected, but a large portion of social stress comes from crossed boundaries. Are you enforcing your boundaries with others? Or do you silently experience your disdain and move on? We all have different needs when it comes to physical touch, emotional connections, and time. For example, some people feel uncomfortable when touched, while others expect a hug when saying hellos and goodbyes. That's why communicating our needs is so important. Some people might feel that others, whether in their personal or professional life, ask for too much of their time or attention. In this scenario, they have to set their boundaries, express their needs, and clearly communicate when the other person is crossing a boundary. Speaking up and saying no might be hard for you. In fact, many people believe that rejection will cause disappointment or conflict in a relationship. And although it will call for a serious conversation, the relationship will only benefit from clear boundaries and expectations. Ensuring that other people respect your boundaries by communicating your needs will reduce your stress and distaste for other people. Number 6. You've been conditioned to hate. Hatred can be learned. It's not unheard of for role models and parents to teach kids hatred from an early age. Those feelings can even be passed down over generations. Consider who you hate and why. Have you heard people speak negatively about a specific person or group of people all your life? If so, you may be judging others based on unfounded opinions. Preconceived notions of who someone is and why you shouldn't like them will prevent you from experiencing a fuller and more loving world. With learned hate, you'll experience more misunderstanding and less connection, cutting yourself off from different cultures and experiences. Even if you have instilled sentiments from your childhood, you can learn to love and accept other people for who they are, instead of for what they look like or what they believe. Number 7. You're envious or jealous. When desire morphs into something ugly, you can find yourself hating other people, based solely on the fact that they have what you don't. Whether you crave their lavish lifestyles, their fat wallets, glamorous social lives, or seemingly perfect happy families, your envy will fester like an open wound. Instead of focusing on what other people have and what you lack, focus on yourself. When you stop wasting time thinking about other people's lives, you make space to prioritize your goals. Instead of thinking that someone has something you don't, which results in jealousy, shift your mindset to think, "I want to and will achieve this by following this plan." This goal-oriented mindset focuses on what you're doing instead of what you don't have. Your jealousy can help you identify your goals, but it won't help you achieve them. If you're always thinking about how other people have more money than you, it could be a sign that you need to set financial goals. Are you going to change jobs, seek a promotion, take a training course, work overtime, or even start a business? If you're concerned about how other people are more fit than you, maybe it's time to set some health and fitness goals. Are you going to stop eating junk food, start weight training, and implement other healthy lifestyle changes? When hatred is based on jealousy, it always signals dissatisfaction. Instead of projecting your negative emotions into the world, redirect your energy inward to identify and achieve your goals. When your life is full of hatred, anger, and disgust for other humans, it often reflects an inner struggle with yourself. This disdain for people can make experiencing positive emotions a challenge, and it will take its toll on both your body and mind. If consistent and strong feelings of hatred negatively impact your life, you may notice that your relationships, work, and personal life are suffering. If you continue to hate others with disregard for how it affects your life, you'll continue to subconsciously confirm the idea that people are generally bad. This confirmation bias will cause you to seek evidence that this belief is true. And as time goes on, your beliefs become stronger and stronger. In the same vein, if you transform your perspective to believe that humans are inherently good, you will subconsciously validate this belief. If you could choose, would you rather live in a world where people are good or bad? Fortunately, you can choose. If you want to lead a healthier and happier life, focus on changing these common causes of hate. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends so we can keep making them. For more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and remember to click on the notification bell. Also, be sure to check out our other videos as well. Thanks for watching